From the moment that I saw you, my life became for you. I'm glad I got to know you. Your spirit made me move on. And I have been waiting all this time, and now I can praise you, God. You
Hey, what's up, everybody? Tony Choi. All right, we got the fake applause in the house. Thank you, my audience. Anyways, what's up, everybody? Wednesday night, 7 p.m. here again. Well, today we were a little bit unjust with the time, but nevertheless, we are here on Spotlight on Latino Live TV. Somos Latino. Hey, guys, check this out. Today we have an amazing show for you guys. We have some amazing guests. Tenemos unos invitados increíbles que le van a traer mucha información desde el mundo de la música, from the world of music to informative. We have a very amazing cleaning company called Trebol that will be with us here. They're featuring a new cutting edge technology that you're going to check this out, and especially made for today and lo que estamos pasando hoy en día con el COVID-19, el COVID-19 with the coronavirus. So it's going to be amazing information. I think it's something that you guys got to tune in with, and it's going to be very effective. We have Vlady Cachay in the house, multi-producer, recording engineer, mixing, mastering, you name it. This guy is super talented in the world of the urban reggaeton market. Nevertheless, I mean, the guy does, I've done music with him myself, and he's multi-genre, multi-talented, and he's with us today also. And I have an amazing friend of mine, not just a friend, but an amazing talent, a lead worship pastor for an amazing, some of the most amazing congregations out there, Trinity Church, Miami, also the VU Church, Miami as well, and he was also in the, if I'm not mistaken, the Church of Cincinnati, but we have him back home again, and we have him here, Mr. Zach Freeman in the house. Ladies and gentlemen, Zach Freeman, let's touch base with him right now. Zach, are you with us?
I'm with you. How are you guys doing?
We're doing fantastic and so honored and blessed to have somebody like you. Not like I just mentioned to the audience, not just a friend, but somebody I really look up to, an amazing father.
Appreciate it.
An amazing father, a man of God, which is something that it overfills me with inspiration all the time. And just to have just to have you around me, brother, it just lights me up, man. You're definitely the meaning of shedding light into the darkness, you know. So
yeah.
Zach, like I tell everybody always, welcome to the show. Welcome to Spotlight.
Thank you so much, man.
Yeah, awesome.
So glad to be here. This is amazing.
Yeah, it's a blessing. I think God has given us a big voice to not just show our talents, but also to be a big voice for our community. This is, like I've
Definitely.
Always said, this is all community-based, and this is to put the community on spotlight, you know, especially, mm-hmm. You know, us as leaders, you know. I think that we have, God has given us a big voice to, you
yeah,
know,
for sure.
To, you know, pretty much, tell people what we're all about. So, Zach.
Exactly, yeah.
I always start with family. You know, as I mentioned, you're an amazing, amazing father, husband, and, you know, leader overall. Tell us a little bit about your family.
Yeah, so I married my wife, Daniela, 8 years ago. And so she is the love of my life. I love her so much. And we have two kids, Noah and Mia. They're both 6 and 4. And so, yeah, I mean, we actually just moved back to Miami a year ago. So, yeah. It's like,
glad to have you back. It's glad great. To have you back.
I'm glad to be back. It's great. And the crazy thing is, you know, we're in Cincinnati. And, you know, it's just something else that we're even, you know, even going to be back here, because I didn't think we were going to move back. I thought we were just going to be Cincinnati and just wherever.
I was praying.
Our life was going to take us.
I was in prayer. I was in prayer. I want Zach back. I want Zach back.
Well, I'm glad your prayers must have worked.
Yeah, absolutely.
We're back, man.
They always do.
Yeah, man.
So, you know, talk to us about this powerhouse mother that you have. Her name is Linda Freeman.
Oh man.
You know, and Pastor Linda Freeman. Let's be corrected here. Pastor Linda Freeman.
She is a very, very special woman.
Yes.
Very hardworking woman. And I mean, obviously my dad is too.
Absolutely.
But I just remember the way she pushed me, the way she encouraged me, the way that she supported me is really why I'm doing what I'm doing right now, because of her. And, you know, she's a woman of faith. She's always speaking faith and encouraging me, saying, you can do anything, I believe in you.
That's right.
But man, yeah, I'm really thankful for my mom.
Absolutely.
But she's been pastoring at Trinity for, man, it must be 21, 22 years.
Yes.
So it's, I mean, that's a long time. It's longevity. It's consistency. You know, it really sets an example for my life, what I want to do, how I want to treat what I'm doing, you know.
Absolutely. And
yeah.
You said a mouthful. I mean, every time I talk to Linda, you know, I'm overtaken by her presence. You know, her spirit is so so powerful, man. You know, and you know, also you're you know, through all this COVID-19, your sister, not just in the military, but she's also in the medical field.
Yeah. So my sister right now is in she's in the Army. She's a lieutenant in the Army. She's in a residency right now, and she's working at Walter Reed. And so right now she's already in the thick of it with COVID-19. You know, she's working from home.
Absolutely.
And they're trying to, you know, be as safe as possible, but she's still in it. And at any moment, they could be deployed, they could be moved around, or, you know, let's say if some doctors get sick. So she's definitely putting herself, you know, on the line for others. I'm proud of her. Very proud of her.
Absolutely, absolutely. Zach, so let's move on. Let's move into the congregation, to your calling, to your purpose. This all is interconnected, you know, with the music. You know, I think that God has set a platform for you to bring forth not just encouragement through the music and through the gospel, but actually, you know, making you in the front line of the gospel through your music.
Yeah.
Talk to us a little bit about that.
You know, the privilege that we have to be able to do this, because we're not just, you know, singing music and writing, we're leading other people.
That's right.
And caring for other people. So that's one of the components that when it comes to pastoring and leading at a church, it's not just the music, but it's also about people. That the care for people and the love for people. And that honestly, if we lead from there first, everything else kind of follows. Because the music comes, you know this, Tony, the music comes from inside of you.
Amen.
It's from inspiration. It comes from a higher place. It doesn't come from yourselves. And so if we put ourselves in a position to be humble and to serve and to love one another, we don't have to worry about where all the inspiration or the creativity is coming from. It's endless, you know, it's always flowing. So for us at Root Church, we believe so much. We love people. People are our heart. That's what we say. And so that's the number one thing for us is people.
That's right.
Reaching people, making sure people are encouraged, making sure people feel loved.
That's right.
You know, God loves you. You matter. We're so glad to see you. All the way that we deal with relationship and just connecting to other people, that's really what drives the music at Boot Church. That's really what drives what we're doing. And now ultimately to honor Jesus.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right. And let me elaborate a little bit for the audience, you know, and you know, I you said a mouthful and a lot of key words, people, love, you know, and that's what our foundation, you know, is built on, you know, rocks, not sand.
Yeah.
And very powerful foundation that we, you know, everything just comes down to love. You know, to love one another. You know, somebody, a great friend of mine today, I said I would quote him, especially Juan Marcos called me today, and he lost his, this guy built a lot of stuff, a lot of businesses, and he lost everything, you know, because of all this stuff of stay home and stuff like that, and he turned everything in. He's a musician as well, and he said, Tony, you know, this just showed me that we have control over nothing. You know, and I told him, you know, we actually do, you know, we have control over loving people, you know, and it just comes down to, you know, that's the only thing that we can control is our heart and the love that we have towards one another. You know, if we have that together, if we have that under control, everything else is okay. You know, nevertheless, Zach, you know, I want to talk to, you know, I don't want to leave this without us talking about your music. You know, you're a huge John Mayer fan. I know that.
Cause,
you know, not just are you an amazing singer, songwriter, but you're an amazing guitar player, brother. You know,
thank you.
That's my fake applause, by the way. But
yeah, I love it.
But
love
here we
it.
Go.
Gotta,
here we go. This is the real one. So, nevertheless, talk to us about that and your passion towards that guitar. And you're like a gearhead. You're a gearhead.
So I started playing guitar when I was 11, and I played through high school, played through middle school, everything. I really got serious about it when I got to college, and that's when I started to listen to, you know, Jimi Hendrix, Steve Ray Vaughan, John Mayer, all these guys, Eric Johnson, and even up to, you know, the guys up today right now, Rich Robinson, man, just so many people. So guitar is another way that I express myself. Actually, before I even started singing, I was singing since I was little, but again, I got really serious about it when I got to college. And then when I graduated and got back to Miami, that's when I started leading worship. But for me, man, Mayor. So into it, man. And I think what got me, honestly, back into leading worship was that I could do kind of what I saw the other guys doing, John Mayer and all these guys. I could bring that into the worship space, and it's from there. It's just kind of been history that ever since. You know, leading from guitar, leading worship from guitar, trying to push the envelope on that. But yeah,
awesome, and you know, give us a little. I mean, only if you want, no pressure, you know. Can you do something a cappella for us real quick, man, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, awesome.
Yeah, let's see. What was I singing the other day? I was just singing something on IG Live. There is no one else for me. none but Jesus, crucified and set me free. Now I live to praise. Yeah.
Wow, so amazing. Amazing. Zach, so let's before we let you go, we have a little bit of time left. Let's just talk about our relationship, you know, how we came together.
Yeah.
And you know, pretty much the music that we've done together, you know, how long we've done without you. You know, we've worked on a couple songs together, and you know, I've already pretty much told you what you mean to me, and just tell the audience a little bit about your experience with me, and how, you know, I know that we met actually at a VU conference.
So we met at a VU conference, and it's one of the conferences that we do at our church, where we really honestly celebrate and come together to worship God. And it's a really large gathering. And I remember through a friend of ours, Matias, and you came, and after the service, because we were at the Fillmore.
Yeah, at the Fillmore.
And, you know, and when you're in that room, it's so electric. It's like, man, it's loud, it's in your faith. The music is just amazing. The preaching is amazing. The atmosphere is amazing, and I remember meeting you in the back, and you were just blown away because you had never seen anything like that in a church setting. And then right from there, we exchanged contacts, and then we just started hanging, writing together, working together. I remember the first song that we did together was "Praise the Lord," wasn't it?
Yeah, "Praise the Lord." Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. Awesome, man. So let's finish it off with just give people a little bit of information. Where can they come and see you?
Yeah.
At the VU, and, you know, all that good stuff.
Yeah, obviously right now we're not meeting in a physical location. We're online, and so you can go at www.vuchurch.com, and you'll see on our webpage on Sundays to log in and tune in to our live feed. We're running our services live online. So everything's the same. The worship is awesome. Preaching's there. And you can check us out. And then also, we just released, you saw the video of us leading worship. That's on YouTube. We just released a cover from Elevation Church called Grapes in the Garden. And so right now, the season that we're in with COVID, we're trying to put out as much content and put out as much music as we can, because that's the way that we're able to connect with people.
Awesome.
So you can check us out at www.vuchurch.com.
Awesome.
Thank you, Tony. Thanks so much.
All right, Zach, thank you so much for being on Spotlight. Everybody, that was Zach Freeman. Make sure
that you
connect with him. He always has music. Check him out. The Zach Freeman on his IG. Also,
yeah, Zach Freeman.
You know, once all of this is back to normal, at least the new normal, we can all go and do Sunday service like Kanye West did over at VU Church.
That's right.
That's
right.
We'll keep it real. Zach Freeman.
All right.
Love you, brother.
Love you, man.
See you soon.
All right.
Okay.
All right.
All right, so we're going to continue, ladies and gentlemen. As I said, we have an amazing show. We keep going, and we're going to have also the next person that we're going to have is actually Trebol Cleaning. Okay, we're going to have Trebol Cleaning. This is Ellen Rivera. She's with Daniel Rivera as well. Not just personal friends of mine for many, many years, but they have an amazing business, amazing cleaning service business that, and what caught my eye, the most part of it that caught my eye was that they have this new technology. They've created una nueva tecnología que han creado esta compañía Trebol Cleaning. Es una compañía de limpiezas. Yo lo digo en inglés y en español porque esto es multigénero, multilingual, you know, bilingual, obviously. And we want to keep you guys extremely in context and informative. So nothing falls off the grid. Nevertheless, we're trying to make connection right now with Ellen Rivera and Daniel from Trebol Cleaning. They have an actual, I don't want to give too much stuff away because I want you guys to actually see and like I said, keep things in context and actually see this new demographic and platform that they have and cleaning technology that is for today's time. And especially for the COVID-19 and coronavirus pandemic. All right, so we are ready, and here is Ellen Rivera and Daniel Rivera. Hola.
Hola, ¿cómo estás, Tony? Muchas gracias por la invitación.
Bueno, muchas gracias por estar aquí. Es un gran honor tenerte acá. Aquí tenemos a Ellen Rivera y a Daniel Rivera. Ellos son parte, bueno, son los dueños, CEO y creadores de la compañía Trebol Cleaning, una compañía de limpieza aquí en nuestra comunidad de Miami, the Tri-Counties. Ellos le sirven a los tres counties y van más allá de todo. Ellos han creado un fogger system, disinfecting fogger system, que vamos a hablar un poquito de eso en breve, pero primero que todo, queremos hablarle a Ellen un poquito de su familia. Y Daniel, y cómo se formaron esta gran parte de esta compañía de limpieza. Ellen.
Sí. Bueno, Tony, primeramente, muchas gracias por la invitación. Como ya tú sabes, nosotros tenemos más de 15 años de experiencia en la industria de janitorial, de limpieza, a nivel general, residencial y comercial, ¿ok? Anteriormente trabajábamos para otras compañías y luego a lo largo de los años de tomar toda la experiencia formamos lo que es hoy en día Trebol Cleaning Solutions, que ya tiene 8 años prestando servicio en el área de janitorial. Somos especialistas en restauración de pisos. Damos servicio a hoteles, a muchos hoteles en Miami Beach, que hoy en día están siendo afectados todo esto del coronavirus. Damos servicio también de janitorial night cleaners a nightclubs, restaurantes y otros, ¿no? Bueno, mira, en vista de todo esto que está pasando a nivel mundial y que nos ha afectado a todos, no solamente en la parte de salud, que es súper preocupante para toda la familia, sino también que nos ha afectado a nivel pues, económico, social, etc. Estábamos viendo pues, con nuestra experiencia de esta semana que estuvimos un poco lockdown, vamos a decirlo así, porque los hoteles están cerrados, todos nuestros clientes han cerrado. Entonces estábamos buscando la manera de capacitarnos y enfocarnos más hacia la parte de desinfectación para todo lo que viene siendo los hoteles, restaurantes, comercios y residencias también que necesitan desinfectar en contra del COVID-19, ¿no? Puede ser para en sitios donde hayan habido personas infectadas, como en otros lugares donde simplemente quieren prevenir, ¿ok? El virus, ¿no? La bacteria.
Claro.
Entonces tuvimos capacitaciones con productos que son aprobados por EPA, que es el United States Environmental Certificate, que son productos certificados, ¿ok? Y aprobados por Sanidad, vamos a decirlo así, para eliminar bacterias desde el VIH y 500,000 bacterias, incluyendo el COVID-19. Entonces, tenemos varios productos, nos empezamos a capacitar productos, cómo se usan y cómo debíamos hacer llevar este proyecto en sí. Y bueno, ya lo logramos. Pudimos sacar la publicidad y bueno, ya vamos a ofrecerle a nuestros clientes. Tenemos dos tipos de servicios que son un poco diferentes, pero ambos son dedicados para eliminar lo que es la bacteria.
Ok, perfecto.
Y bueno, como ya saben, somos muy trabajadores, es una empresa familiar. Yo manejo todo lo que es la parte administrativa, Daniel maneja toda la parte operativa. Nuestros empleados también son gente que se dedica a esto por muchos años. Y bueno, es un momento también para ayudar a la comunidad, ¿no? A todos los que
eso es. Eso es, y para eso estamos acá, por eso me captó mucho el propósito de todo esto, y quiero elaborar un poquito en lo que estás diciendo para explicarle bien a la audiencia de qué se trata esto y cómo esto está dirigido y cómo esto está formado. Mi gente, básicamente lo que Ellen acaba de decir extremadamente constructivo, estructurado, pero tomen algo, ellos han tomado training, entrenamiento específicamente para este Fogger, para esta plataforma que están brindándole a la comunidad, ¿no? Y siempre seguridad primero, safety first. Se han educado demasiadamente bien para ser constructivo en todo lo que están haciendo y todo lo que le están brindando a la comunidad. Ok, so, todo, knowledge is power, saber es poder. Yo creo que tienen algo extremadamente factible para lo que estamos pasando en este momento. So I'm going to explain it a little bit in a nutshell really quickly about what the demographic and platform of Tribal Cleaning is offering right now. Ladies and gentlemen, they're offering an amazing, amazing fogger system, a disinfecting and sanitizing system that they've taken proper training to do for everybody, okay? So this is a system that disinfects and takes away viruses and bacteria. Maybe I'm not being so structured in the information because I'm new to all of this. I think that you guys should do your own research about it. But at any given time, I think that this could be something that could be very effective when it comes to the pandemic and the situation that we're dealing with right now. You could call Ellen and Danielle. We're going to give you all the information so you guys can get in touch with them. And they could bring you more information and be more informative about it. Aquí, básicamente, Ellen le estaba explicando a la audiencia en inglés el movimiento que tienen, que es un movement, el movimiento que tienen ahora a nivel para la comunidad, ¿no? Y básicamente llevar esto a nivel de que la gente se informe bien para llamarlos a ustedes y ustedes como darle la información correcta en cualquier incertidumbre o cualquier pregunta que tenga. ¿Me puedes hablar un poquito de cuándo el negocio se formó? Dijiste que han estado hace 15 años juntos. ¿En qué área ustedes están en el... ¿Tienen una oficina o tienen ustedes un sí. lugar? Okay.
Bueno, nuestra oficina está ubicada en nuestro hogar, vamos a decir, en el Doral. Acá mismo tenemos como un mini storage donde guardamos todo lo que es la maquinaria y esas cosas.
Okay.
Pero básicamente nosotros trabajamos, tenemos también, o sea, las cosas y muchos de los equipos y las cosas en las mismas propiedades donde trabajamos.
Ok, perfecto.
Actualmente la empresa le proporciona tenemos servicios de floor care, vamos a decir así, maintenance, a varios hoteles en South Beach, en la Ocean Drive, varias cadenas de hoteles, de restaurantes, que están cerrados desde marzo, por cierto. La empresa también hacemos night cleanings de varios nightclubs, oficinas, y hemos hecho trabajos especiales como post-construction, cleaning, varios proyectos, vamos a decir, de colegios especiales que no son cuentas fijas, pero siempre estamos dando el servicio, ¿no?
Obviamente.
Somos una empresa 24/7. Eso es muy importante.
Eso es muy importante.
Trabajamos las 24 horas, 7 días a la semana, 65 días del año, 24, 31 de diciembre.
Perfecto.
Perfecto. Y no paramos constantemente trabajando con servicio personalizado, atención personalizada, supervisión, supervisión personalizada. Tenemos todos los que son los seguros, el liability, todos los seguros que eres una empresa.
License, para, fully licensed and insured.
Experiencias que son de muchos años, ¿no? De trabajar en la industria.
Definitivamente. Bueno, entonces, ¿cómo la gente se puede contactar con ustedes para este servicio especialmente del disinfecting y el fogger que ustedes están brindando en este momento? ¿Cómo pueden hacer contacto con ustedes? ¿Pueden dar un número de teléfono?
Me encantaría por un segundito. Ok, el contacto sería vía teléfono, a los teléfonos de la empresa, que es 305-542-3872 y 305-542-6155.
Perfecto. ¿Puedes repetir ese número otra vez o los dos números otra vez? Que ahí
correcto.
Están en pantalla en este momento.
Sí.
Estos son los números en pantalla, pero repítelos a la audiencia. Let's repeat these numbers.
This is 542-872 y 305-542-6155.
Ok, y también tenemos...
El estimado es totalmente gratuito, ¿ok? Tenemos precios especiales para residencias y pequeños negocios, como restaurantes, gente que tiene pequeños negocios, tenemos precios muy cómodos, el precio varía según el square feet, todo para proyectos comerciales, ¿no? Comerciales que son muy grandes, todo depende de la cantidad de esporte. Hay algo que quiero hablarte del System Disinfection, que es basado en ok, eso tiene dos pasos, nosotros lo hacemos en dos pasos. El primer paso es desinfectar todo lo que son las superficies con un producto para lo que es la superficie. Y ya luego de limpiar toda la superficie, vamos a decir, o sea, manillas, puertas, sillas, todo lo que lo puede tocar, vamos a decirlo así, que se desinfecta con la máquina, se hace un... como decir una publicación al
Ellen tenemos una
lanza, lo que es el químico desinfectante que llega a la superficie.
Tenemos una mal conexión. Bueno, desafortunadamente tenemos una mal conexión con el internet. Perdimos a él en un momento. Tribol Cleaning, la máquina de fogger que tienen en este momento. Muy efectivo para lo que está pasando en este momento. Vamos a pasar en este momento a Vladi Cachay, que lo tenemos en línea en este momento, directamente de Chile. Vladi Cachay es un productor de música. Ha trabajado con gente como Alcover, ha trabajado con gente como Gloria Trevi, a Becky G, tiene mucha gente en su plataforma, en su demográfica. Un ingeniero de alto rango, como yo digo, también productor de música. Definitivamente he tenido el honor y la bendición de trabajar con él varias veces. Hicimos una canción esta Navidad, recién que hicimos para Christmas, para Alcover. También y trabajamos en una canción, otro sencillo que tiene Alcover también. Y ahora está mezclando una canción para mí que se llama Miami 305. Quizás que la vamos a lanzar este verano. Toma parte mi hijo Anthony Choi y mi sobrino Eric Easy Bankro. So, básicamente, we are ready to roll with Vladi Cachai in the house. Vladi, Vladimir, ¿qué me cuentas? ¿Estás aquí? Vladimir is with us. So, Vladimir está con nosotros. Tenemos como un delay de 3 segundos porque Vladimir está directamente de Chile. Obviamente, por el pandemic y el COVID-19, no ha podido regresar hacia nosotros porque él vive también aquí en Miami. So, no ha podido regresar con nosotros. So, pero lo tenemos vía video call desde Chile. Vladi, ¿estás con nosotros? Estamos tratando de tomar la imagen con Vladimir.
No nos escucho.
Vladimir no nos escucha. ¿Aló? Todavía. Vladimir, ¿me escuchas ahora?
¿Aló?
Hola. Tenemos imagen, pero no lo tenemos en...
No lo escucha usted.
Ah, sí. Lo tenemos en imagen, pero no nos escucha a nosotros. So, estamos tratando de ver... tienes... sí.
¿Aló?
No sé...
¿Tony?
Sí, ¿me escuchas? ¿Me escuchas? No creo que ese es el apellido, creo. ¿Sí? ¿Sí? Ok. So, perdimos a Vladimir. Estamos tratando de reconectarnos con Vladimir. Obviamente, le estabas comentando a ustedes la trayectoria que tiene este gran artista, no solamente artista, pero músico, ingeniero y productor, y la relación que tenemos nosotros como colegas. Él le va a hablar a ustedes un poquito de cómo his involvement in the music business, his multi-platform. I'm gonna explain it to you guys in English because I know I have a lot of audiences in English, so we're trying to connect again with Vladimir, and so just bear with us. Obviously, as you can tell, this is a live broadcast, so at any given time we try to keep things rolling, and I'll keep talking to you guys. We've been working on a lot of music. We got Vladimir again. Vladi, ¿estás con nosotros? Aquí estamos. Hola, Vladimir. ¿Nos ves?
Sí, ahora sí lo escucho.
Y me escucha, perfecto. Bueno, Vladi, como siempre, le digo a todo el mundo, bienvenidos a Spotlight, aquí en Latino Live, somos Latino. Vladimir en la casa con nosotros, mi gente, directamente de Chile. Vladimir, ¿cómo estás? ¿Cómo te sientes, Vladimir?
Bien, muchas gracias por la invitación. Súper bien por acá. Súper bien.
¿En qué parte de Chile estás? ¿En qué parte de Chile estás?
Estoy en la capital, en Santiago de Chile.
En Santiago de Chile. Ahora me acaban de comentar que hay un delay de 7 segundos. Wow, that's a long time. Eso es un largo... Okay, so we're gonna try to bear with this. Vladimir, te voy a preguntar una serie de preguntas y ahí con este delay de 7 segundos tratamos de como que comunicarnos de una manera u otra, okay? ¿Me escuchaste? Se frizó. All right, so we lost Vladdy again. So production team here is trying to bear with the situation and the connection. But listen, at the end of the day, we're doing the best that we can. So, I mean, like I said, I keep on telling you guys, this is a live broadcast, and we'll bring you some extra news. We have, at the moment, I want to say to you guys that we have, we are being blessed with 100 meals a day, okay? So, Victoria DeSilvio is bringing us all the way from Merrick, Meisner Park. They're getting from all the different restaurants in Meisner Park, they put together 1,000 meals a day. And these 1,000 meals a day, they bring them to the students, obviously, that are home, and obviously they're studying at home. But we get blessed with 100 meals a day. 100 meals out of those 1,000, we get blessed with them. They are here at the channel. So at any given time, we're going to give you guys the information. So you guys can come, anybody can come and pick up the meals. There'll be one person. There'll be a table and there'll be one person serving these meals, okay? So we supply these meals to you guys at no cost whatsoever. You guys just come and pick up the meals. Obviously, we'll have the way of doing with the social distance and comply and make sure that you you wear the mask and you wear the gloves. And we can supply you guys with the meals. So we have over 100 meals, and we could supply you guys with it. So I believe that we got Vladimir back here. I don't know if we do. Vladimir, ¿estás con nosotros? Vamos a
tratar. Sí, ahora sí.
Ahora sí, ok, perfecto. So, tenemos el delay de 7 segundos, so vamos a tratar de hacer lo mejor posible para hacer la transmisión, ok. Ok, Vladi, entonces háblame un poquito de
perfecto.
Ok, háblame un poquito de tu carrera musical. Obviamente yo le he estado dirigiendo a la audiencia de tu trayectoria. Y la demográfica y plataforma que tú trabajas como ingeniero, como productor, como compositor también. Háblanos un poquito de tu carrera.
Bueno, mira, como les contaba al principio, yo vivo en Chile, o sea, estoy en Chile en este momento. Acá ya llevo casi 20 años produciendo. Hace un tiempo atrás, 8 años, estuve en un docu reality aquí en Chile, que fue muy exitoso. Que se llamó Los Méndez. En ese docu reality me hice muy conocido como productor musical. Pero, donde produje varias canciones que fueron hit acá en Chile. Pero, con el artista que era el principal de ese reality, con su familia.
Perfecto.
Y ya desde el 2015 que tomé la decisión de viajar a Miami, de ir creciendo autor, como ingeniero, y se dio la posibilidad de viajar todos los años, hasta el año pasado, 2019, que tomé la... una artista chilena que se llama Paloma Mami. Hace poco trabajé con Chino y Nacho en el nuevo single que sacó. Con Gloria Trevi. Estoy bajo con la producción de producción del disco de Alcover también, trabajando a la par con él.
All right, perfecto. Entonces,
Y de varias canciones que ya vienen pronto.
perfecto, perfecto, buenísimo. Entonces, no, 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 no quiero dejar, no quiero dejar esto sin hablar un poquito también de lo que tú representas a nivel urbano. Creo que lo perdimos otra vez. Okay, so but let's go ahead. Ladies and gentlemen, sorry about today, about all of this connection and the internet. We're gonna end off the show and we're gonna end off the show right now with a little bit information. Like I talked to you guys about the meals. Okay, so I'm trying to see how we could get production so we could go outside and I could show you guys pretty much what we have as far as the meals are concerned and how you guys can get in touch with us and that way we can show you guys how to come over and pick up the meals. You don't necessarily have to come tonight. You could come tomorrow. Tomorrow we'll have a table set up outside and you guys can come up. And the boxes will be there. You guys can pick up the meals and go as you go. So, ladies and gentlemen, one more time. My name is Tony Choi. This was Spotlight with Latino Live TV. Somos Latino. Okay. I will see you guys. Hopefully, you know, if God allows, I will see you guys next week. Same place, same channel. 7 p.m. We're gonna bring you some more guests. We're gonna bring you some more information. We always have amazing guests with us, and at any given time, artists, entrepreneurs, you know, businesses themselves. This is a community-based show, and we're all live, as you can see. So we will go right now to show you the meals delivered by Victoria De Silvio. We also have Anthony. Anthony wanted me to give him a shout out. So, hey, what's up, Anthony? Thank you so much for every day bringing those meals all the way from Boca over here. And let's bring you guys outside. Okay, I'm gonna bring you guys over here. We're walking. All right, so as promised, we get 100 meals a day, as you can see. These are all the meals, ladies and gentlemen, full gourmet meals, okay? So at any given time, you guys can come and pick them up. We will set everything up for you guys outside, okay? We're gonna put them outside on tables. You guys can come in yourselves. We'll have somebody directly with gloves and masks, you know, just, you know, with the social distance. You guys can come at any given time and pick up the meals yourself. We also have salads as well. We have some salads as well. So very healthy. We have keto meals at any given time as well. And just to give you guys some information, we have these meals delivered to us each every day, Monday through Sunday. So if you don't pick them up today, you can pick them up tomorrow. You can pick them up the next day. Don't feel shy. This is all in a moment of need. We are pretty much all the same. I'm sure that there's a lot of families out there that need the help, and we're here to facilitate you guys with the help. Okay. Once again, this is all community based. You know. Latino Live TV, alongside Anthony De Silvio, Victoria De Silvio. We also have many foundations connected with us. We have Driven by Faith Music Ministries, that is my ministry, Cabell Events, We've included a lot of different companies. We're also partnering together as well with Link Construction, Guillermo Fernandez. So we're giving everybody a chance to be on Spotlight. Once again, we're pulling together. We are unifying together at any given time. So 100 meals a day, Monday through Sunday. Guys, my name is Tony Choi. This was Spotlight on Latino Live TV. Somos Latino, como siempre decimos. Este fue Spotlight. Mi nombre es Tony Choi.